Children, welcome back to my channel. Again, today we are going to just finish off the last part of the lesson, Should Wizard Hit Mommy? This is part 3, written by John Updike. Again, we are only going to do the exam-based explanation. That is, we are just going to cut off all the unnecessary dialogues and we are going to stick to what is required for the exam. As a bonus, I'm going to give you the entire recap of the story in as short as possible version at the end of the this video. So please watch the video till the end. If you are interested in going through the main parts of the lesson part by part for the quick revision, then I have provided the links and you can go and revise them in those links. We all know from the previous part that Jack extended the story because Joe was not paying attention. Instead of Roger Creature living happily, when Roger Skunk went home, his mother did not like the smell. She wanted her baby to smell like a skunk again, and that is why Mommy Skunk took Roger Skunk to the wizard, hit the wizard on the head, and then asked him to make her baby smell like a skunk again. And after that, Skunk and his mother went home and they heard the train bringing Daddy Skunk home from Boston. And they had lima beans, celery, liver, mashed potatoes and payo mai for dessert. When Roger Skunk was in bed, Mommy Skunk came up and hugged him and said he smelled like her little baby skunk again and she loved him very much. The other creatures got used to Roger's smell and didn't mind him, so they started playing with him. Jack and Claire. Jack and his wife Claire had two children, Joe and Bobby. Claire was pregnant with their third child. Claire was moving the furniture and painting it. Jack did not like her doing it but said nothing. The woodwork, a cage of moldings and rails and baseboards all around them was half old tan and half new ivory, and he felt caught in the ugly middle position. He did not like what he saw. He did not want Claire to do the man's job. Yet he did not tell her anything, but he felt he was caught between something new and like ivory which is shining and an old tan, old paint, and he felt trapped in the middle. Though he felt his wife's presence in the cage with him, he did not want to speak to her, work with her or touch her. So this is the end of the story. There are differences between Jack and Joe. Jack is an experienced person who is old, and that is why he wants Joe to understand that all endings are not happy endings. You have to be practical. Joe is a very small child. She wants everything to be happy and the world to be ideal. That is why she is asking Jack to give the story a happy ending. Now, the bonus. I am telling you the entire lesson in as short way as possible. Jack told his daughter Jo, who was just 4.5 years old, a story in the evenings and for afternoon naps. The story outline was the same. What was the story outline? There was a Roger creature who had a problem. He went to the wizard who solved the problem. Roger paid the wizard and returned home happily. This was the Roger creature and this was the basic story. And that Saturday, it was Roger Skunk. Roger Skunk smelt very bad. He went to the wizard who changed him to smell like roses. He smelt very beautiful and Roger Skunk was very happy. At this stage, when Jack was telling her this part, Joe thought that the story was over and started looking out. She didn't pay attention to him. This displeased Jack, so he extended the story. When Roger returned home, Mommy Skunk did not like the smell of roses. She said, "Who is this? You are not smelling like my baby." She took him to the wizard and made her baby smell like a skunk again. Slowly, the other creatures accepted his smell and started playing with him. This was the story ending. But Joe was afraid. She did not see it as a story. She saw it as real. She did not see it as a story alone. She insisted that Jack change the ending, but Jack wanted Joe to learn a lesson, so the story ending remained. Jack then went down to his wife Claire, who was 6 months pregnant. When he saw her painting the furniture, he was filled with disgust and felt caught in the ugly middle position. He didn't feel like speaking to his wife, working with her, or touching her. This is the end of the story. So if you like what you saw, please comment and please let me know if you have any difficulty. Thank you.